one really interesting and fun thing to do in space engineers is to create little automated drones that can perform a variety of tasks. And you can do a fair bit of it without applying any scripts. So I'm going to show you the basics of how to create drones, give some tips on how to make them work better, and talk about some things that seem a little beyond the ability of our wonderful little automated workforce. So I started this drone work with a simple project. I'm going to fast forward you a little in the series to talk about this drone operation because I became completely infatuated with all the things a person can do and set up in the game through these drones. I had built this really nice mining ship, or at least I thought it was nice. It held a little over a full cargo container worth of ore, was armored, had some reasonable defenses and a large ore detector, stone ejection, mag plates for docking or carrying salvage, 10 megawatts of hydrogen power generation to function as a mobile generator, a large hydrogen tank with 2 hydrogen oxygen generators, and even an oxygen tank and cryo chamber, so I could log out without dying on extended ore recon and mining trips. Basically, it was the complete mining package with a lot of extras, and all fit in an extremely small form factor. Its only drawback is that if I took it to one of the planets with full gravity, like the Earth-like planet, I would burn a huge amount of hydrogen, just leaving the atmosphere, and I couldn't even lift off carrying its fully loaded 1,600,000 kilograms of cargo using its 880,000 kilograms worth of lift. So I wanted to build an add-on module to the HM25 miner that had atmospheric thrusters and could cruise the planet's surface on long excursions, carry more weight, and leave the atmosphere without burning through a third of its hydrogen tank. I also wanted to attach and detach this Atmo module at will and make the whole attachment detachment process fully automated with drone technology. So you start by making your drone pretty much like any other ship that has the essentials. A power source, thrusters in all directions to maneuver, a gyroscope, and any cargo containers, guns, or whatever you need. You should also have an antenna. Even though it's not technically required to operate the drone's autopilot, it helps a ton, and you'll see that with the setup. And it also helps to take control of the drone as needed. Now, when building your drone, the main thing you need to make it work is a remote control block. The remote control block serves 2 functions, really. It allows you to remotely control and fly your ship, just as if you were in a ship, and it allows you to set basic instructions into the block that will fly the ship on autopilot to one or more destinations. Placement of the remote control block doesn't matter much if you're just remote flying a ship, but if you want to do the automated pilot drone thing, then placement is more critical. For the autopilot to make the ship travel, you'll set GPS waypoints, and the center of the remote control block is where the drone will fly when it goes to one of those GPS points. So for instance, if you want a very precise location, like needing to dock it to a connector, then I highly recommend placing the remote control block centered over the connector. You can see here, I have mine right over a merge block, which I'm using for part of the connection. I'm going to use it for docking the module to the ship, and then use the connector off to the side for docking it to the station. I actually have 2 remote control blocks, but I'll cover that in a moment. Depending on what you're doing, you might need more than one of those.
Interesting.
The main thing the remote control block is going to need are GPS coordinates you'll enter as waypoints. The GPS coordinates are the same ones you create on the GPS screen your character has, most often by selecting New from Current Position. In fact, that's pretty much how you'll create your drone's waypoints, just with a little twist. The easiest way to set the waypoints, particularly for a precise location like docking, is to use the drone itself. Your character has an antenna. The drone has an antenna and a remote control block, which means you can fly the drone. To do that, press K, go to the top where it says remote access, select the drone, and press control. You're now in control of the drone. At this point, any GPS coordinate you set will not be centered on you, but the dead center of the remote control block. So you can start by setting a GPS coordinate while it's docked. Then fly the drone straight up a little bit to clear the connector and set another coordinate, and then any other coordinates you want. That same coordinate set a few meters above the connector can also be used when the drone returns to align it for setting back down on the connector. My setup was simple. 4 points. One at the station dock, another a few meters above, another above the ship, and a fourth at its docking position on the ship. And I was able to just fly the drone ATMO module to each location and set the GPS coordinates. Those GPS coordinates will appear in your normal list of GPS coordinates and will also be available for selection as waypoints inside the remote control block. Add the coordinates as waypoints in the order you want. Once your waypoints are set, you can have the drone perform other tasks at each waypoint. You highlight the waypoint and go to the setup actions. For instance, I had my drone turn on the merge block when it reached the location above the ship. Then, when it reached the final location directly on top of the ship, I could briefly turn off the engine to allow it to fully settle and complete the merge. I did that brief cycle of engines with a timer block. You can activate a timer block as an action, which can be very helpful if you need a short delay between actions or need to further sequence actions at timed intervals. You can also activate another remote control block. Really, you can perform just about any action on any block. There's also a few more things to make things work as well as possible. You may want to set the maximum speed down and turn on precision mode when making a final docking maneuver, or really any other fairly precise operation, like flying through an area of your base, or going to a location, turning on a drill, and then slowly mining the rock before returning to unload, which is one reason why you might want a second remote control block. Even though you can reduce the speed of a drone as one of the actions in the remote control block, it may not be as precise as you'd like, as those increments tend to be in pre-designated chunks. So you could transfer control to a second remote control block that's already set at a very low speed that you deem perfect for mining. There are other settings that could be important. You can set your drone to patrol, which will fly through the waypoints in the order loaded, then go backwards through the waypoints until it gets to the beginning. The circle operation will follow the series of waypoints, then immediately return to the first waypoint and start the series all over. One way is exactly what you'd think. It goes through each waypoint, then stops when it reaches the end. For me, none of these options really fit what I wanted the drone to do when I wanted to return it back to the station to redock. You might think I could just use the patrol option, but it wouldn't work in my case. I was going to load the ATMO module onto the ship, then go do things with the ship. When I came back to the base and started the autopilot, it would want to start right at that first waypoint on top of the station dock and not at the ship. So a second remote control block where I could set the starting order in reverse would do the trick. So that's another use case for having more than one remote control block. Because the GPS waypoint coordinates center on the remote control block that's currently controlling the drone, I did have to set a new series of coordinates for this second remote control block so everything would line up right. It wasn't a big deal, and it was only one block above the other one. If you're really savvy and can figure out what the orientation is on your grid regarding X, Y, and Z axes, you could create an offset set of coordinates just by manually entering the distance in meters between blocks. Large grid blocks are 2.5 meters big, but now I'm getting into a whole different topic on grid sizes. One thing the autopilot does have trouble doing is spinning or rotating a ship on its axis if it needs to line up with something like a platform for landing or a docking connector. And that's particularly true if you have a ship in space. If the drone gets askew, or maybe needs to reconnect to a ship in space, it might require some manual intervention to get things lined up. But I'm still looking for ways to do it without scripts. An engineer never quits. If you've found a non-script way to rotate and reorient a drone in autopilot, I'd love to read about it in the comments. I think I've just scratched the surface of drones and the game in general, but I'm off to more engineering, more discoveries, and some updates on the multiplayer DadSpeed server I'm playing on. Check out the trailer and join the fun!